stars of the wildly popular show Friends. He's this one right here. There he is. It is Thursday nights on NBC. He's obviously on the cover here. People, I'm going to circle it here in case people are not familiar. There we go. Please welcome Matthew Perry, folks. Welcome, Matthew Perry. Success.
Thank you very much. I'm very glad you circled.
I did circle it.
Because all mine at home are circled.
You know, it takes a while. Even when a show is a hit, though, sometimes people go, I love that show and that third guy.
Exactly.
It takes a while, but now people know, they know who you are.
What helps for you to circle me on national television?
This is not your first show, right? You've had a few other shows.
No, yes, I've had a couple of other shows that never graced the cover of People
No, what
magazine.
Shows? What shows did you have?
The first show I did was a show called Boys Will Be Boys that I think is kind of famous and epic because out of 93 shows on television, every single week it was ranked 93rd.
Really? I never even heard of that. When was it on?
Well, because it was ranked 93rd.
Oh,
never heard
of it.
There was one week, actually, that we went to 92nd, and we threw a huge party.
Oh, really?
Huge. It was nuts.
Was it a half-hour deal?
Yes, it was a half-hour show. Not a bad show. It just didn't work.
Just didn't work. Yeah, 93. That would tell you something.
That's not
okay,
working.
That's one. Is that the only one?
No, there were a couple of others. I did two other television shows that got canceled because of Robert Stack.
Robert Stack?
Yeah. I'll explain further.
Yes. Please, go on.
Oh, yes, of course. Well, I did two television shows called, one called Home Free and one called Sydney. With Valerie Bertinelli show.
That's the one in France. That was Cafe
no,
or something.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I remember that one. Oh,
Jake's a big fan of my prior work.
Oh, yeah.
and they were both on against Unsolved Mysteries and, you know, the juggernaut of Robert Stack.
That was a huge show. Get wiped out, but that's not, now you're wiping other people out.
Yes.
So you feel good.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I just ran over Robert Stack in the parking lot.
Oh, really? Now, are you guys all through for the season now? Have you done all the shows?
Yes, we finished a couple of weeks ago.
Oh,
so.
What an easy gig sitcom. You see, and you have like months off. We hear every day you have like months off. What do you do? Do you do movies or something? Or what do you do?
Well, yeah, I'm talking about possibly doing a movie or...
I'm talking about it too, but I'm not getting anything. Every guy in this town, every waiter is talking about it. Sure, I'm thinking of doing a movie. More veal piccata? What do you mean?
I just sit in a parking lot just going, I'd like to do a movie, please.
Have you got one? Have you got a movie?
Well, no, not right now. What happened? I got a script got sent to me that I got really, really excited about, and it was one of those rare times as an actor when you read a script and this part just like jumps out at you.
It leaps,
if you will, and says that I should play this part. So I was really excited about it. I went into the audition, and auditioning is kind of a strange thing, and you see a list of all the actors that went up for this part, and I was saying, I wonder who is going up on this part that's perfect for me. This will be interesting to look at. And three lines above me, the person who went in three times before me for the part that's perfect before me, perfect for me, Gary Coleman.
You and Gary are up for the same role?
Gary Coleman and I. And I see him at almost all my auditions. Gary Coleman, Matthew Perry. And so I decided to put that completely out of my mind and go into the audition, you know, and forget all about that. And I read, and it was going, I thought it went really, really well. And the director said, okay, Matthew, that was pretty good. This time, could you take it again and try to behave a little bit more like a short black man?
Oh, so they're not looking.
Then I knew that I was finished. Anyway, Gary, good luck with the film. I hope it all goes well.
Somebody got it. Well, that's good. That is it, amazing, though. You still have to audition. Even, you know, you're an established star. You're on a hit show. And they, because I know the few auditions I've gone through, when you're like the 30th or 40th person to go in, and they do that fake, if it's a comedy scene, they go read the scene, and then they go, you know, fake laugh to make you feel better. And,
yeah, it's worse when it's followed by, get out.
Yeah.
That's the worst.
Now, here's something I did not know about you, because I've done jokes about this guy. Your dad is an actor. His dad is the Old Spice sailor, right?
Yes, he is.
He's the guy that go and throw the Old Spice. Oh, that's me.
Yes, he is. Yes, my father is a freakishly good-looking man.
Yeah.
And you can imagine the level of, I will never, ever bring a date home.
That's kind of, ooh, have your dad. That's like a Geraldo.
I want to meet your father. No, you can't, because I'd end up, alone for the rest of the night.
Now, see, some of the women on our staff want to be asked, now, are you like, seeing someone? You're not married, right?
No.
No. So do you have a girlfriend? Do you go out with anybody on the show?
No, that would be against, you know, Friends rules.
Oh, yeah. you can't date
someone on the show. No, I'm kind of just, you know, single guy right now.
So you're not seeing anyone? So you're not dating anyone? Now you must have your pick of women out there. You're on a hit show.
No, well, you know, you want to find, like, Miss Wright, and I'm out there doing that.
Oh, please, don't give me that phony act. Come on, now, what are you going to do? You're not seeing anyone special?
I've got 12 women in the
restaurant. Uh-huh. Well, tell me that story about Jennifer now.
Oh, well, this
Jennifer Aniston on the show, which would be this cute one right here.
Yes, that's the one not circled.
Not circled. Well, let me just show. Now, I saw this. Now, I said, this has got to be like a thing for sweeps. There's a scene where she has a nude scene in the TV show.
That's correct. It's one of my favorite days in the history of days.
Now, how do you talk an actress into a nude scene on a TV show where there's no nudity?
Well, the scene is basically that Chandler walks in and catches Rachel naked in the apartment. And I turned to her one day and I said, you know, I'm method. I'm a method actor. And, you know, if you're just going to be 50% naked, I'm only going to be able to give you 50% of a reaction.
Mm-hmm. So she is naked in the scene?
Completely naked. You know, you'll see.
Is that the clip we have?
That's the clip you have.
Oh, good. Do you have the outtakes?
I have all the outtakes.
Well, let's take a look. This is from Friends. All right, here we go. You walk in, she's completely naked.
Yes.
Now, did you have to do a lot of takes? Did you find yourself screwing up a lot?
I kept asking for more takes.
More? I know I can do it better.
Yeah, I kept tripping over things and saying that I'm going to need the rest of the afternoon on this.
Oh, man. So what are your summer plans now? What are you going to do? So you're not doing a movie.
Yeah, we're talking about the movie thing. So, you know, we'll see. But what I'm going to concentrate mostly on is finding a very good ice show.
Ice show?
Yeah. I've been thinking of trying to, you know, convert some of the classics into ice form. You know, Swiss Family Robinson on ice, Waiting for Godot to skate by.
Right. Well, that sounds...
Things like that. So, you know, my goals are high this summer.
Yeah, it's good. And summertime is a good time to think about an ice show.
Exactly. Yeah.
Are you a good skater? Do you skate?
Yes.
Stupid conversation. Are you really a good skater?
I do. I'm not really looking for an ice show, but I am a skater.
Yeah, you really are a skater.
Unless a good ice show.
That's it for your plans? You're just going to goof off? Interested in dating?
I'm going to goof off a little bit. I'm going to visit some family. I'll probably date a little bit.
Now, do you show? Well, let me tell you. When you go, I know you were born in my part of the country. Where did you grow up primarily?
I grew up, I grew up a little bit in Williamstown, Massachusetts.
Okay, now when you go back, you sort of walk around and kind of flash this to all the people you used to know
The nice thing about that is I'm getting recognized a little bit because I'm on a show that people are actually seeing, and I always wanted to get recognized, so what I'd have to do before is, if I want to get recognized, just go up to people on the street and tap them on the shoulder and tell them I'm on television.
Well,
they'd be like, oh yeah, you're that guy, and then it would work out. Now I don't have to do that.
Well, that's great. Well, congratulations.
Well, thanks.
Your show is terrific. You do a great job.
Thank you very much.
Right after this.